Natural convection occurs due to the buoyancy forces acting on a fluid with density gradients, resulting from the variation in the temperature within the fluid. Now, depending on an application, natural convection can be the sole mechanism of convective heat transfer, or it can occur in conjunction with forced convection. Normally, flow velocities associated with natural convection are small compared to velocities in forced convection. But depending on how strong the forced convection is, natural convection's contribution can be significant enough to be included in the overall heat transfer analysis. But when is this contribution significant enough to warrant inclusion? Another important question for natural convection flows is how can we determine when the induced flow will transition from laminar to turbulence? The answer to these two questions lies in two very important non-dimensional numbers, and in this lesson, we will find out what they are. So let's get started. Let's begin our discussion by looking at the dimensionless parameters that govern natural convection. Consider the following set of non-dimensional variables. Here, L is the characteristic length and U0 is the reference velocity. If we deploy these non-dimensional variables, then the x momentum and the energy equations reduce to the ones shown here. The dimensionless parameter in the first term on the right-hand side of the x momentum equation is the contribution of the buoyancy force. If we choose the reference velocity U0 such that it is given by this expression, then the coefficient of the d-star term in the x momentum equation becomes unity, and the corresponding Reynolds number can be written using this expression. The square of this Reynolds number is defined as the Grashof number. It is a dimensionless number that represents the ratio of the buoyancy forces to the viscous forces acting on the fluid. Therefore, it plays the same role in natural convection that Reynolds number plays in forced convection. Heat transfer correlations in natural convection are typically a function of the Grashof number and the Prandtl number. In cases where the forced and natural convection effects are comparable, it is more convenient to choose the reference velocity as the free stream velocity U infinity. In this case, the coefficient of the T star term in the non-dimensional equation is no longer unity, but is of the form of the ratio of Grashof number and the square of the Reynolds number. For such cases, the resulting Nusselt number correlations are now a function of Reynolds number, Grashof number, and the Prandtl number. Now, depending on the values of this ratio, we can have the following three conditions. For cases where the numerical value of this ratio is very less than unity, natural convection effects may be neglected, and the Nusselt number correlation is a function of Reynolds number and the Prandtl number. When this ratio is very large, forced convection effects can be neglected, and the Nusselt number correlation this time would be a function of Grashof number and the Prandtl number. When both the numerator and the denominator are comparable, combined effects of both natural and forced convection needs to be considered, and the Nusselt number correlation is a function of the Reynolds number, Grashof number, and the Prandtl number. Such situations are referred to as mixed or combined convection. In these scenarios, the natural convection may help or hurt the forced convection heat transfer depending on the relative directions of buoyancy induced and the forced convection motions. If the buoyant motion is in the same direction as the forced motion, then the natural convection assists forced convection and enhances the effective heat transfer. A simple example of this flow setup is an upward forced flow over a hot surface. On the other hand, if the buoyancy-induced motion is in the opposite direction to the forced motion, then the natural convection resists the forced convection and decreases the overall heat transfer. This flow setup can exist in our example if we just switch the location and direction of the fan in this way. We can also have a situation where the buoyancy-induced motion is perpendicular to the forced motion. This type of transverse flow enhances fluid mixing and in the process also enhances the heat transfer. For example, consider the horizontal forced cross flow over a hot cylinder as shown here. The Nusselt number for mixed convection is often expressed as this. Here NU forced and NU natural are determined from existing correlations of pure forced and natural convection. The plus sign on the right-hand side of the equation is for assisting and transverse flows, whereas the minus sign applies to opposing flows. The value of the exponent n varies between 3 and 4 depending on the geometry involved. It is observed that the value of n equals 3 correlates with experimental data for vertical surfaces pretty well, and values of n equals 3.5 and 4 are better suited for transverse flows involving horizontal plates and cylinders or spheres respectively. Now let us analyze the boundary layers corresponding to natural convection. We begin our analysis by considering natural convection on an isothermal vertical surface immersed in an extensive ambient medium as shown here. The governing equations of natural convection must be solved subject to the following boundary conditions. Ostra obtained a similarity solution by introducing a similarity parameter of this form. The velocity components can be defined in terms of stream function as shown here. Now we can write the x component of the velocity using the stream function like this. Similarly, we can compute the y component of the velocity as this. And using the dimensionless temperature, the three partial differential governing equations are reduced to two ordinary differential equations. Here f and t star are functions of only eta, and the double and triple primes refer to second and third derivatives with respect to eta respectively. These are the new transformed boundary conditions for this system of equations, which can be solved numerically to obtain a solution. From Newton's law of cooling for the local convection coefficient h, the local Nusselt number can be expressed using this expression. Now using Fourier's law, we can obtain the heat flux as shown here. And therefore, we can rewrite the Nusselt number expression like this. We can see that the dimensionless temperature gradient at the surface is a function of the Prandtl number. This Prandtl number function can be expressed in this form using interpolation. Since we already know the local Grashof number can be expressed using the following expression, we can express the average convection coefficient for this surface of length L as this. Integrating this expression, we get the following expression for the average Nusselt number for the surface of length L. Now substituting for local Nusselt number at N, we get the following relationship for laminar natural convection on a vertical surface. Hydrodynamic instabilities may arise in natural convection boundary layers, and as a result, disturbances in the flow may amplify, leading to a transition from laminar to turbulent flow. Transition in the natural convection boundary layer depends on the relative magnitude of the buoyancy and the viscous forces in the fluid. In such situations, the occurrence of transition can be determined using the Rayleigh number, which is simply the product of Grashof and Prandtl numbers. Rayleigh number can be viewed as a ratio of buoyancy forces and the product of thermal and momentum diffusivities. In the case of vertical plates, the critical Rayleigh number is 10 to the power of 9. With that, we have come to the end of this lesson.